I'm going to talk today about avoidance and anxiety. When people get anxious, they might get it really extreme and they decide to avoid a situation they're not very comfortable in or they find very scary. Okay, now that's the worst thing you can do. In the short run, it's nice because you think, oh, I'm not in that scary situation right now, so I can relax in my own home and do what I want, okay? And that makes you feel better, like, instantly, okay? But in the long run, it's really going to make it harder work for yourself, whereas you might actually feel like you need to bring someone in that situation with you, and you're relying on that person. Now, that's the worst thing you can actually do, guys. You've got to actually face the situation. You've got to feel the fear. You can't fight the fear. You feel the fear. You might get these nasty symptoms like the sickness, the chest tightness, okay? It's nothing life-threatening. It's just sensations. If it's life-threatening, I'll tell you to flip and go to the hospital, okay? It's not life-threatening at all. Okay, you just have to sit there and face the situation, okay? Because the next time you go into this scary situation, it's going to be get a little bit easier for you. And it might actually find that it's not making you anxious at all, and yet you just do it without thinking of worried thoughts or nothing like that, okay? So never avoid situations. When we get anxious, we get out of breath. We either gasp for breath or we have shallow breathing where you feel like they're not breathing much at all, okay? That's very scary, but it's just sensations, okay? Now, fresh air might help you, so go for some fresh air, it clears the mind as well, and helps you breathe better, okay? Because we lack carbon dioxide when we're anxious, so... yeah. Okay guys, I'm gonna go now because I've got people coming around right now, okay? Join me in the next video tomorrow, about 2 o'clock I'll do it. Take care.